basically what I'm going to do is I found a little base for it, center it. We put a little harp set on it. And then, so then I can harp it and do a really cool finial on top. And this piece is so old. So the sockets that had gone in there, they don't make anymore. So what I had to do was I had to come up with a way to put the sockets, because they were like porcelain sockets that just, they were perfect fits. So basically I had to come up with a little contraption and make it fit. So what I'll do is I'll put something in like this, and then I saw these were holes for screws, so I found this piece. I'm going to put it in like that. I'll screw it in, and then it'll sit just like that, and I gave it a new pull chain.
Week 5 of Meet the Mayor, and this week I want to thank Brian Cool of Shades of Soho for allowing me to spend some time in his store at 175 Rock Road. One thing I hadn't pointed out as we hit week 5 is that so far every business owner that I've spoken to and shacked up with has been a resident. So Brian, like everybody before him, is a resident. So by supporting your local businesses, which there are 1,000 good reasons to do it, reason 1,001, it's one of your neighbors who's trying to run a successful business. So let's help them out, shop local. And Brian's going to talk a little about his wonderful store that he owns with his wife, Tara.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. Also, thank you, Glen Rock TV. I think it's really awesome that you're going around and meeting all the stores and highlighting them. It's something very much appreciated. So at Shades of Soho, we actually make everything here in our store. We hand sew our own lampshades. We make our own lamps, we make our own chandeliers, we make sconces, and we do all kind of lamp restoration, refurbishing. Anything from just a small minor lamp repair to a complete restoration where we replate it or just refinish it. Last night I was actually with my son. We were having frozen yogurt, and out of nowhere, I don't know why he said it, he goes, "You know, if I was to have a store, I think I'd like to make something instead of buying something from someone and selling it to them," he goes, "because it just makes it special." And then after he goes, he's like, "But I'm 7, what do I know?" But he actually hit it right on the head, because it is what makes our store special. We make everything. We actually put a lot of tender love and care into everything that we do. We watch everything closely. And what we do, you can't find much anymore. There's really no mom and pop lamp and shade shop anymore. We started out as a manufacturer. My college roommate, who's in the back making the shades, we went to work after college. We had gone to work for a lamp manufacturer whose father started in 1924, and his son was then running it around 70 at the time, and he had no kids going into it. So we bought the company, we built it up to 107 employees. We had a really cool production line of ladies just sewing. And then we realized one day we can't manufacture in this country, in the state anymore. So we opened a little outlet store in our factory. It started to really have a great presence. And so then one day I woke up, and at the time, we had 7 vacant stores in the downtown. And I was like, my wife had just given birth. So I said, I think I'm going to change the business. She's like, go do whatever you got to do. So I was out here getting a prescription for her at CVS, and I was sitting outside the store, and I was like, you know, I think our store would make this town really cool. I think it would add something to the downtown. And it was vacant, this space, for 2 years prior to us taking up the store. So I sat there, and I was like, well, let's come up with a name. And I was just going, Lampshades of, Shades of. I saw a train going by, heading to New York City. I'm like, Shades of So. It came to me pretty quick. Awesome. And it was a pretty cool name, because everybody still calls, and they're just like, you know, I really love the name of your store. So it's been great. We've had people come from all over the place. A couple came this morning from Maryland. We deal with a lot of sentimental pieces, things that belong to parents, grandmothers, great-grandmothers. People don't want to ship a lot of these pieces, so they'll actually take a trip. Usually it's retired seniors that have the time and the money, so it's a great clientele. But we've also gotten great support from the town. I walk through the downtown, and I'm amazed at how many people I actually know that I'm like, wow, they were in our store. Or I could be in, you know, a food store, and I'm like, one time I actually went with my son to somebody, and I, I thank them for being supporting our store so we can have food in our shopping cart.
That's good. That's very good.
All right.
So it's a great story, and we walked around a bit, and in some sense, you know, you're not just making these from scratch. You find lamps sometimes at garage sales,
yeah.
Or sometimes you find one person. They say one person's trash is another person's treasure,
exactly,
or something like that.
Yep.
And you guys take that to a whole other level, because a lot of these beautiful lamps were once decrepit-looking, rusted pieces that you're giving a whole new life. And I think that's great.
Yeah, customers would bring them in, and their reaction when we would give it back was, you know, they were amazed. So I was like, why don't we just do that for our store also? Because a lot of the older pieces are, all the older pieces are way better than what you can get in a store today.
That's great. Well, great job. Thanks again for
having
me here, and thanks for being in our
Appreciate
town,
it.
And you do a great job.
Thanks.